China's third aircraft carrier, the Fujian, Type 003, represents a significant milestone in the country's naval modernization drive. It is the first fully indigenous flat-top carrier designed and built entirely in China, featuring a catapult-assisted takeoff and barrier-arrested recovery CATOBAR system instead of the ski jump ramp used on previous vessels. The ship's 80,000-ton displacement makes it one of the largest conventionally powered warships ever built, comparable in size to the U.S. Navy's Nimitz-class carriers, which displace 100,000 tons. As Fujian gets ready for commissioning with sea trials, a critical flaw has got exposed. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why China's Fujian is still not a match for 50-year-old Nimitz-class. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. At the heart of the Fujian's technological leap is its use of electromagnetic aircraft launch systems, EMALS. After Ford class, this is the first carrier to have this technology. EMALS are different from steam-actuated catapults. Steam-actuated system requires a lot of steam piping, a large condensate return, and tons of fresh water. They tend to require quite a bit of maintenance. Plus, with steam catapults, the majority of the force gets transferred to the airplane at the beginning of the stroke, in a jolt. This puts stress on an airframe and thus reduces the lifespan of the multi-million dollar planes. EMALS uses a linear induction motor with an electric current to generate a magnetic field. That field then propels a carriage down a track. Since the power delivery is linear, it negates the deficiencies of the steam catapult. These catapults allow aircraft to take off with heavier payloads or in greater fuel loads than the steam or ski jump systems used before. The carrier is equipped with three EMALS tracks and an electromagnetic arrestor system for recovery, enabling a new generation of carrier aircraft, including stealth fighters, early warning aircraft, and support planes, to operate from its deck. The island superstructure has been reshaped into a compact, radar-reduced profile, integrating advanced sensors, phased array radars, and communication systems. As the ship prepares for operational deployment, analysts and observers have pointed out several potential flaws in its layout and design after a documentary titled Charge Toward First-Class Military Strength was aired on Chinese CCTV on August 5th. In the documentary, the Fujian flight deck control room was shown. The most widely discussed issue concerns the placement of its catapults relative to the landing runway. The second catapult reportedly overlaps the end of the angled landing area, while the third lies within the landing strip itself. This arrangement prevents aircraft from being launched from two of the three catapults during recovery operations, limiting simultaneous launch and recovery cycles, a crucial factor in sustained carrier air operations. Even the forward catapult, which does not intersect the landing path, must be cleared each time a recovered aircraft crosses it en route to the maintenance area. On September 15th, the military commentary platform Haishifenbong cited this scene to argue, simultaneous takeoffs and landings are a minimum requirement for large carriers, 80,000 to 100,000 ton class. Yet the Fujian, despite being a large carrier, cannot perform them. The article argued that Fujian's number two catapult line overlaps with the end of the diagonal landing runway, while the number three catapult is located within the landing strip. As a result, the number two and number three launch lines cannot be used during landings. Furthermore, while the number one catapult line does not overlap with the landing strip, landed aircraft must cross it to reach the maintenance area. The article added, the Fujian's J-15 fighter is a heavy aircraft, requiring significant runway length to stop. During landings, both the number one and number two launch lines are effectively unusable. It added, both of the catapults are situated close to the middle front section of the landing area, So either the J-15 or J-35, China's two carrier-based fighter jets, would roll over the catapults when they land, temporarily preventing them from being used for launch operations and thus affecting the takeoff efficiency of the fighter jets. This deck layout could significantly affect the Fujian's sortie generation rate, the number of aircraft a carrier can launch, recover, and prepare for the next mission within a given time frame. By comparison, U.S. supercarriers, refined through decades of operational experience, have optimized deck geometry and procedures to maximize continuous air operations. Some estimates suggest the Fujian's sortie rate might reach only about 60% of a U.S. carrier's under similar conditions. The Fujian's technical design does introduce some forward-looking elements. Its integrated mass combines radar, electronic warfare, and communication systems into a single enclosed structure. The flat deck configuration, larger aircraft elevators, and potential for operating unmanned systems all reflect lessons learned from foreign carrier programs. But its combat effectiveness is below par when compared to Nimitz-class. Add to the flight deck issue, the absence of nuclear propulsion. The Fujian relies on a conventional power plant, meaning it will depend heavily on logistics support for refueling and sustainment during extended deployments. This limits its ability to project power far from home waters for prolonged periods, a capability that remains a key advantage of nuclear-powered carrier fleets. Further, the vessel's overall effectiveness will depend not only on hardware, but also on operational experience. True carrier proficiency is built through decades of at-sea flight operations, logistical coordination, and maintenance under combat conditions. China is still in the early stages of developing the human and procedural infrastructure needed to sustain a modern carrier strike group. From deck crews and aviation technicians to replenishment units and escort coordination. In strategic terms, the Fujian represents both progress and transition. It is a powerful symbol of China's expanding maritime ambitions and an experimental platform that will influence the design of the next generation, likely the Type 004 carrier, which is expected to feature nuclear propulsion and more refined deck geometry. Lessons learned from the Fujian's deck layout, launch procedures, and propulsion limits are almost certain to shape the successor. Ultimately, while the Fujian may not yet match the operational tempo or endurance of its American counterparts, it demonstrates China's determination to bridge that gap.